It says here, when our deputies came into your house, they found one beat-up skinhead who's been arrested several times for hate crimes with a shotgun in his possession, one handcuffed girl who may or may not be a prostitute, some potential Johns, and three handguns that were used to kill a family pet. No one has made any statements, so the only thing we can do is charge you for the possession of the three handguns, two of which killed a family pet.
I don't know anything about that. I was throwing a party, and those guns were probably left by some unruly partygoers. And I was going to return them to the authorities, but I was so busy entertaining.
That's your story?
Yes, I guess.
Well, that's not good enough. Either you tell us the whole story, or you go to jail. Explain yourself, or go to jail, you choose.
What guy? Looks like a bunch of fags playing strip poker. Aren't you guys supposed to be delivering pizzas or something?
Jeremiah, the Rosses have called three fucking times. I think you're gonna miss out on the tip.
Like I did the last six times. They're getting the prompt service they pay for.
Speaking of prompt service, I've been working at Gianni's for 7 years now. You know what that means?
It's about time to kill yourself?
Yeah, keep talking, day shift. I had to kick down for Ronnie's stripper when he hit Lucky 7. Time for you guys to kick down for my stripper party. And if you want any hours next week, remember I write the schedule.
A benevolent fucking lord you are.
Hey, Abajan, won't your girlfriend get jealous?
Nah, he and Rosie Palm have an open relationship. At least, he doesn't speak up when she's servicing other guys.
Yeah, you guys could talk if you kissed any chicks besides your moms.
You know, your mom's actually pretty good. A little invasive with the tongue, though.
If anyone here can afford a stripper, it's you.
If you guys want any hours, work on that stripper.
You got it, Abajan. Male or female?
We know what you want. Alright, I'm out of here. Jeremiah, deliver that pizza or I'll deport you.
Hey, keep talking that way and I'll go to work for Shakey's. And then you'll feel really bad.
Later.
Later. Later.
That cheap fuck. Man, I don't want to have to chip in for his lap dance. What good are some fake titties up in your face if you can't count on that ass?
Yeah, fuck a stripper, get a hooker.
I think you've got that backwards.
Well, I mean, sure, we could get some lame-ass skanky stripper for $100.
Nah, 150, low ball.
Blue ball?
Exactly. Should let him lick some whipped cream off her snatch. Maybe for an extra 20, he'd get a hand job.
Yeah, 20.
What would that get him? I mean, hand job, but eh, free ones are hard enough to handle. I say hooker.
Well, they cost about the same. Some are even cheaper.
Not that it matters to you, but they're illegal.
Just like Hector.
You're just being lazy. Call girls, or escorts, are in the yellow pages.
Yeah, but those pages are always stuck together.
You know, we could just go to TJ. Some of the prostitutes there are actually pretty hot.
Sure. And give them some disease.
And those scabs take forever to heal, eh, Hector?
That's why the guy's never got any.
That guy's not right in the head.
Fucked in the head.
And that's why he gets no head. But isn't that why we're doing this? I mean, virginity is only a virtue for chicks. I've never heard of a girl bragging about her boyfriend being a virgin.
I think we're taking this a little too far. He'll come around, eventually. He's just a little sexually underdeveloped, you know, a couple years behind the rest of us.
All you pussies are underdeveloped compared to me. Dude, he's 27. By the time I was out of high school, I'd bagged me a baker's dozen.
Point is, the guy's missing out. And it's up to the homies to help a brother out.
Look, even if we could find a hooker or call girl for $100...
Doubtful.
He wouldn't do it. He'd want the first time to be, you know, special. With a special girl.
Yeah, well, if he waits much longer, that special girl will be a special ed girl. Imagine all that drool.
You know, special ed girl wouldn't be so bad. Blind chick couldn't see you cry afterwards, Mike D.
Yeah, well, that mute chick still manages to talk shit about you, Hector.
So, we're back to wasting our tips on a stripper for a badge.
Shit. Regardless of a badge, I always vote hooker.
TJ Hooker?
Wait, that gives me an idea.
I think Bill Shatner would charge a little much.
Yeah, I know he would. That guy's gone Hollywood.
No, an actor. She could be acting.
Pay a hooker to fake the whole thing?
I think they usually fake it anyway.
Not when they're with me. Half the time I'm making money.
Listen, we get a hooker. Pay her the usual fare. She pretends to be some random girl, enraptured by his wit and charm.
Abajan?
They go back to his place and get it on.
Well, that would be some acting. I see Julia Roberts in that role.
Well, that's all there is to it. He thinks she's a regular girl. She gets to buy her pimp a new hat. Maybe the guy will loosen up a bit. Stop being such a dick. Everybody wins.
Wait, how the hell do I benefit?
Yeah, when do I bust my nut?
And where are we gonna find this Oscar-worthy hooker?
Hector.
Hey, don't look at me. I don't want one of my regulars to suddenly become that guy's sloppy seconds. But I could give you a few leads.
Are we doing this to actually help him out? Or is this just something we can make fun of behind his back?
You mean like the dog licking peanut butter off his dick?
That's the first time I heard of a dog dying of high cholesterol.
Yeah, one too many lap-lap dances.
Poor old Skippy. So are we really gonna do this?
So we'll be trolling for whores tonight? Cool.
That's better than whoring for trolls. Tell bead.
You guys, just watch out for a girl who calls herself Opalescence.
Why? A dude?
Nah, something worse. Far worse.
Well, I got something worse for y'all.
Cause it's Domino, motherfucker! No, it's
That's not.
That's
not Domino.
It's not.
Dude!
Oh, God! That's disgusting! Put it away! Hermanita, ven conmigo.
Y sufrimiento. Donde no hay sufrimiento. Me perdieron, pasa por la calle. Isla de canto. Me voy, me voy, me voy. Nuestro propio animal. Canta a la gente pa' gratis. Hey, babe, what are we doing?
Find some whores.
Hey, how you doing?
Oh shit, a customer.
Hey, we got this friend, he's a virgin and...
Hell no, not me, I won't do it. First time gotta be special, gotta be romantic and shit.
Yeah, my pussy's romantic. I'll do your boy for 50.
How about 35?
That's cool. Does he mind balls?
Well, Orchidia, how much would it be for you to approach our friend in a bar?
No, I can't go in no bars. I can't go indoors.
Why?
It's my pimp. He's like so jealous. I'm not allowed indoors.
Make the sale, honey. Make that sale.
Yeah, that's like your boy.
Do you have any diseases?
Leukemia disease.
Hey, how you doing?
Not bad. How about you?
Oh, pretty good. Hey, we've got this friend. We're wondering if you'd have sex with him.
Sure, I'll have sex with him, but he can't suck on my tits, though, because these little fuckers teething.
Hey, baby, how you doing?
Good and shit.
So we got this friend, he's a virgin.
Wow, shit, that's cool.
Yeah, so, you know, would you have sex with him?
Hell sure.
So, how much is it gonna be?
What do you mean, how much?
How much do you charge?
You think I'm a prostitute? What the fuck? Just because a girl like dick, you think she's a prostitute?
No.
Fuck you! Your friend just missed out on the best pussy of his life!
Dude, she was free! Think I missed out on my chances?
What the hell are we doing?
Dude, I don't care about Abajan. I'm having fun.
Seriously, this isn't gonna work. Let's just give up on old Mission Impossible.
Yeah, I don't see any pretty women are leaving Las Vegas out here. It's more like gummo.
These women are a lot more expensive and nastier than I thought they'd be. Maybe Abajan just wasn't meant to be with a woman.
So we should get him a puppy.
Oh, hey, let's swing by the Rosses. I gotta drop off this pizza. Or what's left of it, anyway.
Hey, Sloopy, how you doing? When are we gonna go out to that lunch I owe you?
How long ago did you break up with that guy? He's still trying to bridge the gap?
Well, call me. I'm pretty sure you have my number.
If you mean the gap from friend to significant other, I'm working on it.
I meant filling the gap like cocking the crack.
It's a difficult thing.
Hey, Mike, it's Danielle. Guess what? I've been living in Del Mar for the past 2 weeks. Let's get together tonight. My band is playing a concert at Soyo. You should come. I put you on the guest list. I miss you. You'd better come. Bye.
I got it.
What?
Danielle.
Who?
Danielle, the girl I went to prom with, the one from San Jose.
Oh, the girl you didn't sleep with, that we never met, who probably doesn't exist?
Yeah, she'd totally do it.
Do what?
Do a Abajan.
Really?
Yeah.
Sup, fag?
Hey, big boy. Who wants to go eat?
Dude, Mike D's got the hookup.
Huh?
Danielle, has made a prom date?
Oh, yeah, isn't she the deflated one under your bed?
Danielle's perfect. She's pretty hot. She'd totally do it. For a reasonable price.
Yeah, what kind of standards does this chick have?
Well, she did go to the prom with Mike.
I hear that.
Danielle's the only girl I know who would admit to sleeping with a guy just for his money. Remember when that movie came out about the guy who paid $1 million for Demi Moore? I talked to her about it. She said she'd totally do that. For a significantly cheaper amount.
Like free pizza?
Speaking of which, I don't know if it's worth it. I don't want to chip in for some 10-second investment. If it were me, I'd take my time. I'd get my money's worth. But this is his first time, and I doubt he'll even make it through the consensual agreement.
Two pump jump.
You cheap bastards.
Besides, couldn't we just get him one of those fake pussies? They last longer than any girlfriend.
Fake pussy, what do you say
that? That guy next door is getting weirder all the time. At least when he was in school, he had some interaction with people. Pretty soon we're gonna find heads in the freezer, and love letter bombs addressed to girls we went to school with.
Seriously, I already saw some young Laotian boy running up the street naked, bleeding out his ass.
Dude. But then I did see Hector drive away.
Hey, a Laotian boy is a lot like a Laotian girl.
Hot?
Nah, worth about $10 to her parents. Fine, I'll kick down for a charity case.
Thank you, Albert Schweitzer.
Wait, Danielle won't give him some disease or shit, will she?
Danielle? No.
If you'd sleep with someone for $1 million and then I talked you down to $200?
Dad? Oh, hey, Mike.
Hi, Daniel.
Did you like the show?
I didn't like the first few songs, but the rest were good.
Jeez, you're so flattering.
I'm kind of pissed you didn't call me till today.
Oh, it's been so insane. I'm moving, I've been working at the aquarium. Then we found out about the show. I'm so sorry. How can I make this up to you?
Are you still seeing Kurt?
Kurt?
Don't you ever touch Danielle!
No, we've been broken up like forever. Mike?
Hmm?
Why do you ask?
I was just thinking maybe we could help each other out. Do you remember me telling you about my friend Arnie Abajan?
Your neighbor, the guy who had sex with a dog.
Oh, he didn't have sex with that dog. Uh-huh. It's just a very amusing rumor.
What about him?
He's a really nice guy, but he's a little negative, and because of that and premature balding, he's never actually been with a lady.
I've heard legends of such men, but you actually know one? Please introduce me.
That's the funny thing, because I was thinking maybe you could help the guy out.
Hey, Danielle, just wanted to let you know the band broke up and we voted your ass out.
Fine, get the fuck out of my dressing room. I'm a survivor. Goths are such wimps. So, define help the guy out.
Have sex with him.
What? You want me to have sex with your nerdy dog-molesting neighbor for...
$200. Cash.
It would basically be like every other relationship I've ever had, except I would have cash instead of jewelry or clothes.
Here you go. Oh, I'll keep the receipt in case something doesn't fit.
It will save us both time, but why isn't it here?
That's another thing. You're gonna have to do a little acting for your money.
Oh, I can fake orgasms. But I usually don't have to. Did you say something?
No. He, Abajan, will never agree to having sex with a hooker. We just wanted
to... What is this? Are you in some kind of boyer club?
No.
And I am not a hooker.
Of course you're not a hooker. Abajan will just want the first time to be special, you know, romantic.
What do you want me to do? Bring some flowers, light some candles? And I'm a virgin?
That'd be some acting. No. We'll just be at a bar, you come up to him, take him back to your place, and have sex with him.
What, he lives at home?
Yeah, but doesn't it make sense in this economy?
What exactly are you getting out of it?
I would just be helping a friend get out of a rut and into the groove.
Maybe he's in that rut for a reason.
Yeah, well, that's because all women aren't as understanding as you, Danielle. I would have hated to be the woman who could have prevented the next Ted Bundy. Personally, I couldn't live with that guilt.
Why now?
I don't like the way he's eyeing my little brother. Plus, he just bought a knife collection from QVC. So would you do it?
Christ! I've got a potluck supper tomorrow! What the hell am I gonna tell the Sisters of Job, huh? I ain't going to hell for this, all right? This guy doesn't play those games, all right? Have you even read the Bible? Jesus Christ, huh? Well, let me summarize it for you in two words. No shenanigans.
So sleepy, this guy keeps calling. Making orders, sending packages.
Yeah.
Well, I thought he called a lot to check on orders, you know? Then he started getting more and more persistent.
Yeah.
Well, I was beginning to think he liked talking a little too much. And then he started getting more than a little flirty, you know? He talked like phone sex.
Really?
Yeah, it was totally gross. He started panting.
Wow.
Ugh. So anyway, I told him to get a grip on himself.
I'll bet he did.
He sure did. He stopped immediately. Told him I would never
talk to him again if he ever did anything like that.
You sure know how to take care of business.
You bet I do.
A woman who knows what she wants.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah!
What are you talking about?
Nothing.
Whatever. Anyway, what are you going to be doing later tonight?
I don't know. Read a book? What about you?
I'm going to the gym.
Yeah. I was thinking about going for a run myself. So are you taking a class, or?
Yeah.
Oh, really? What class?
Yoga.
Hmm. So, have you learned to put your legs behind your head yet?
Not quite yet. I am getting pretty limber, though. It's great for your body.
So what do you wear to that class?
Yoga pants, and...
Is that call waiting?
Sure.
Are you gonna get it?
You bet. Hello? Mom? Mom!
Dude, ready to go?
Yeah.
You're not going out like that.
Hey, going out!
Come on, put on a shirt.
This is a shirt.
Put on a shirt.
What, I'm dressing up for a shake?
No, we're gonna go to that Chuggers place. Chugs and jugs, dude.
Yeah, this will be awesome. Yeah. Check this thing out. This is bad.
Yeah, horrible. Let's go.
What's up, Jace?
Hey.
Pretty nice kilt.
It's a woman's skirt, but it fit.
Barely.
What are you laughing at?
These nights on Tuesday.
Then why are we here tonight? We should be here on Tuesday, right? Huh. We're here tonight because we're supposed to get a bunch of weight. Ooh. 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 Monumental challenge.
Chicks, huh? Why don't you ask her to dance, John?
Watch you. Show her those classic robot moves you got. I heard the robot's back. Isn't that what you tell the girls at the junior high dances, John D?
No, I just tell them I'm in tight with SpongeBob.
Hey, at least I don't say I'm gonna go talk to chicks and then just sit here.
Yeah, you're like an agoraphobic James Bond. You wuss out and won't even consider talking to chicks.
I want to count my chickens before they hatch.
Hey, you're not afraid to choke your chicken.
Why would he be afraid?
Hey, there's a chick for you. Why don't you go ask her to dance?
Figure if I wait, they will come.
Yeah, that theory works about as well in the bar as it does in the bedroom.
Chicks aren't like Cornfield's dreamer.
I don't see any chicks here, just chickens.
Would you stop talking about poultry? No girls want to talk to guys who are sitting chatting about barnyard fowl.
Oh, what if we were talking about fashion? They just flock to our table.
Speaking of chickens, I'm gonna take out that fucking rooster that crows from 4:30 a.m. Me Mexican neighbors won't do anything about it, and neither will the cops. I guess it's in me own hands now.
What are you gonna do?
Let's just say you can call me the Jackal. Cuckoo. Hey, there's a girl for you. She's plenty lacking in self-respect. If her heart's in the right place, you may stand a chance, Abajan.
Yeah, right. Like, I go for a chick like that. You guys might think I'm desperate, but give me some credit. Got such great eyesight, why don't you go ask her?
I'm waiting to be pissed.
You know, I'm waiting for a chick to get so drunk, I won't have to use any of my contraband pills from Mexico.
Come on, roofies. They're so 98.
I'm waiting for a chick to get so drunk that if I strike out, I can come back 5 minutes later and ask her again. I'll have to look out eventually. It's the law of diminishing expectations.
So you guys got that stripper lined up yet?
We're still in the screening process, Abajan.
Hi, welcome to Chuggers. 300 beers from around the world call us home, and now you can too. What'll it be, fellas?
All of them are teeny. Dirty. Very dirty.
Great.
All around the globes. 300.
Whew. Well, what beers do you have?
Would you like to look at our list?
No, just rattle off a few. The good ones.
Okay. Stella Artois, Guinness, Oosgraven Ale, Corona, Dos Equis, Newcastle, Deja Brew, Carlsberg Chronic, McEwen's Wine Hearts,
What about this five-country sampler?
Well, like it says on the card, any five beers from any five countries.
What are some of the choices?
Would you like me to name some countries?
Yeah, leave off France. No fag beer.
Afghanistan, Algeria, Argentina, Australia, Austria.
What about Andorra?
Chuggers doesn't officially recognize the sovereignty of Andorra. Bangladesh, Belgium, Bolivia, Brazil, Belize, Bulgaria, Burma, Cambodia, Chile, China, Colombia, Congo, Cuba, Denmark, Dominican Republic, Ecuador, Egypt, El Salvador, Ethiopia.
Well, what do you recommend?
Well, they're all really good.
Well, which one do you like?
I don't drink. I'm Mormon.
I'll have a beer from latitude 65 north, longitude 20 east.
Iceland, Helge Magre, Gaxmajor.
Yeah, sure, whatever. Beer's beer, right? All comes out as piss.
All right. And for you?
I'll take a pint of bitter from the Bunny Moors in my homeland.
Foster's.
What? I'm Scottish.
Would you like a real Scottish beer or a fake one like your accent?
Mickey Shagger, if you've got it. If nay, a bud.
All right. And how about for you?
Me? I don't know. Wine.
We've got a Cabernet Sauvignon, Merlot.
Cooler.
A wine cooler.
Fag.
Okay. And how about for you, Mr. Fancy Dresser?
A Coke. Just plain old Coke.
Yeah, big spender. Big drinker, too. Yeah, just a Coke. I'm the designated driver, too, so I don't pay for this, right? Just don't want any of this beer shit. It's probably like $4. $4 for a glass of something that tastes like shit? Makes sense.
So a Coke? All right. Be right back.
What a homophobe.
What? Me? I'm no homophobe. Look, I'm gay. See? He's the homophobe. He's the one I love.
Watch and learn, fellas.
Front, back, side to side. I want to get inside.
Sure, you are an ass.
Well, it's ass.
Big booty house, help with it.
Very dirty martini. What's your wine, Coop? Your Coke? Foster's. Have the mag.
I don't think this is even Coke, it's Pepsi. No fucking tip for this bitch. Like, I can't tell the difference between Coke and Pepsi. 300 million beers and they can't even have a drink of fucking Coke. God, this is like shit. Fucking Pepsi. God. Yeah, she can't deny this physique.
Dude, did you see that?
Yeah.
Do you wanna dance?
I don't really dance.
Not even with me?
I can't dance.
Part of his parole.
He's just kidding.
He's being modest. Come on, Abajan, show her your moves.
Yeah, show me your moves.
Well, well.
Damn. Fucking A, so that's Danielle.
No. I don't know who that is.
What?
Of course it's Danielle.
Maybe I should make a withdrawal for myself, and then my own deposit.
You know, getting a chick like that might make it worth working at Gianni's another few years. I bet he's already bust a nut.
That explains those dance moves.
I think Danielle's a trooper. Do you think she really likes him?
Yeah, I think he's won her heart.
boy is finally gonna become a man.
Yep, and I hope he uses a Jimmy if he knows what's good for him.
Wait, Abajan and Hector drove. Does the bus even run this late?
Don't worry, there's Hector.
What's up, you fine bitches?
Hey, did you finish with that chick already?
Nah, she wasn't down with the hip, yo.
You gonna spare some change?
Yeah, sure.
How much extra for no condom? Get in.
Dude, I think she was cheaper than Danielle.
Yeah, you see how excited she got about that quarter? I think we've been hacked.
He's got the right idea, though. We all have to go home and rue.
If we can get back home.
Give me 15 minutes. I'll get some ice cream sandwiches.
Abajan, where are you?
I hate fucking chickens.
I'm telling you, if you let your doppelganger give you a blowjob, it's not masturbation, it's sodomy.
What's a doppelganger?
If you go to another dimension and meet yourself, that's your doppelganger. I'm telling these two guys, if you ask them to go down on you, you're gay.
What do you mean if I could give myself a blowjob? Oh, that'd be like the best blowjob ever.
Tell me about it. I'd know exactly what to do.
Man, I'm the only one who completes myself.
Exactly. You have to tell chicks way too much. More teeth. More teeth. Bitches, you fucking canines.
No, auto fellatio is just masturbation.
So you come in and you say, get ready, self. I'm gonna freak you wild.
Illegal in most states. Sorry, Tennessee.
Now what about our sex with the doppelganger? Is that up for debate?
Yeah, right, that's only for fags.
No, in certain communities, it depends on whether you're given or taken. Oh, those lucky boogers.
What guy? How can you talk like that?
I guess we'll never know.
Not until we find a wormhole in the space-time continuum.
Or until we buy a Craftmatic adjustable bed.
What is it, honey?
It's for you.
What is it?
It's $5.
Money? Why?
I wanted to give you something. It's not just any $5 bill. The numbers on it are a Fibonacci sequence. Do you know how rare that is?
Thanks. Let's go back to bed.
Okay.
Dude, what are you doing?
Oh, stiff neck.
Huh.
Stretching. All right, Abajan.
Get some, dude?
Dude, did you see that chick? She was insane. You guys could never get a chick like that.
I know. You're stoked. So what happened?
Let me put it this way. I don't think I'm going to be needing that stripper anymore.
Oh, yeah? Do tell.
Okay, well, she asked me to dance. And
you both get into your car.
Yeah, and I'm driving, and she asks if she'd like to go get a drink. And I say, where? So she said she had some champagne at her place. So we drive over to her place. Pretty sweet pad.
So, did you do her, dude?
I'm getting to that. Okay, so she pours a couple glasses of champagne. Man, that shit is sick. How can people drink that shit?
It's booze. You know, moral lube.
Oh, so she puts on some music and lights some candles, and right off, we start talking about sex.
How'd you contribute to that conversation?
If there's anything I know, it's chicks. Okay, so we started kissing, and then all of a sudden she took off her shirt.
Consider a cheating now. Red hair with a curl, mellow
go. Darling, sweetie.
How are you, dear?
Oh, I'm still walking, okay? Come in.
So, would it be a little too perverse if I asked how it was?
Why would it be perverse?
I don't know, but don't be graphic.
Well, right after he shot his first load.
Ooh. In or out?
Out. But he recovered quickly. He's a decent size.
Decent?
He was really aggressive. Or maybe I should say ungentle.
Rough?
Immature.
That's fair.
He does seem a little unstable.
What's wrong with the Abajan?
A lot. He never stops complaining, and he kept tapping things. At some point, for some reason, he gave me a $5 bill that belongs in a museum or something.
He must really like you. That's his lucky $5 bill.
Well, next time I'm gonna ask for more money.
Next time you're going in the biz now?
Next time with him.
Danielle, perhaps you misunderstood. We asked you to break him in. Pop that cherry. One-time deal.
He loves me.
He... Wow, what makes you think so?
He told me.
Last night?
Yes, and in a letter.
He wrote you a letter?
He's written me letters, plural.
Well, could have been worse.
It was worse. He said the worst thing a guy can say.
What? You're fat. No, wait. Mom?
No, thank you.
That's the worst? Sounds kind of polite.
Yeah, to someone that gives you change, but it just reminded me of a pathetic person I just fucked.
That's a little harsh. Wanna go get lunch?
Sure. I'll treat.
Looking for my Pixie CD.
Dude, I hate fucking Pixies.
Yeah, I know, sorry.
Dude, what are you doing? You couldn't imagine?
No, I dropped my toothbrush in the toilet and I had to get it out.
Why'd you have to get it out? Are you gonna use it again?
No.
Then why is it back in its holder?
Dude, because it's clean now.
I don't know. Leave me alone, I'm in the bathroom.
Dude, Abajan, what are you doing with your retirement box?
She never returns my calls.
Who?
Who? Danielle. Talk to her once, she said she'd be busy.
Maybe she is busy. Or getting busy.
I don't understand, it went so well.
Don't worry, dude. Once you conquer the first chick, they're easy pickings.
Not like her. She was perfect.
Dude, she wasn't perfect.
For me, she was. What do you guys know about this chick, anyway?
So what are you gonna do?
I don't know. I gotta find a way to win her back.
It's right here.
Dude, that is so fucking nasty.
Wait till you see it. Wait till you smell it.
Wait till I use it.
Hey, guys.
So what are we gonna do about Abajan?
Ah, he'll snap out of it eventually. He's a new man. He's been with a woman. Do you know how many more chromosomes that is closer than a dog?
Or an FP.
What?
Maybe she should do it again. I mean, he's dying. He's like a flower. Having seen the sun once, is now withering in darkness, cold and alone.
Gosh, that's beautiful.
I hate to tell you this, but we've interfered with the normal development of an abnormal man. There's another date. He's probably gonna start stalking her.
Start? He's already bought one of my guns.
Really?
What? No! Did she like him at all?
Yeah. He's all things to all women. No.
Well, maybe she'd be willing to do it again.
Maybe they should go out on a dinner date.
What, guy? The purpose of this was to get Abajan past that little virgin hurdle, not to pimp full time. I mean, he gets the next girl in 7 more years.
No, seriously. I mean, he needs closure. Otherwise, he'd pine over her forever.
Yeah, see, he thinks she's perfect. So they go out again, she acts a little weird, he diminishes her value, and then she breaks it off officially. And he can move on about his sad little life.
It's a good idea, I guess. You guys gonna chip in?
I'll get you next time.
Hey, next time.
Next time. You cheap bastards.
Whatever, I'm going to work. See you guys.
Catch you later, John D.
Later. Alright, he's gone.
So that's an FP.
God, that's disgusting.
I don't know. Looks pretty realistic.
Well, that's why it's disgusting.
Does a badger know about this new low?
Maybe your brother needs Dr. Danielle.
Hey, Danielle. So has Mr. Wonderful been calling?
Every day. Why didn't you warn me he was psycho?
I thought I did. Hey, if you hadn't worked your black magic woman stuff so well. Speaking of, you have any spells that'll lure him away from your tempestuous desires?
There are no spells that powerful.
What about another date? Dinner, movie, something? No sex?
No way.
Hear me out. This time when you go out with him, you act like a total bitch, kind of put him off, and then at the end of the date, you tell him you don't want to see him anymore.
Why can't I see him anymore?
Because he creeps you out. Because you don't like him.
No, what am I telling him?
Oh. What do you normally tell guys?
I normally don't go on a date with a guy just to break up with them. I ignore their phone calls and file a restraining order if necessary.
Okay. We'll keep that in mind. How about you don't have any time? How about you're moving back to San Jose in 4 weeks?
The truth.
Yeah, a version of it.
Okay, but this had better be a nice dinner, and $150.
What about Vigalucci's and $75?
You're trying to barter for my worth.
Well, if you want to talk fair market value, I mean.
Okay.
I'm sorry I got you into this, but this is the best plan I have to get you out.
Thanks for looking out for me. What about after that, you and I go out?
On a datey type date? I'm kind of seeing Erica.
Kind of.
Yeah, you know, trying to make that leap from friend to lover.
Kind of like the opposite of us.
Yeah. Except we never did it.
Oh, yeah. Not yet.
Hey, Abajan. I was thinking about Danielle. I was thinking you have to understand her perspective.
What would you know about her perspective?
I understand the female mind. See, you picked her up at a bar, took her back to her place, had your way with her. Maybe she feels cheap and used.
Well, when we talk, with the messages I've left, I talk about going to the park or to the beach, you know, romantic.
See, that's your problem. A girl likes to feel special. I say give her a call and leave a message. Not desperate, not whiny, just classy. Invite her to the nicest restaurant in town. Say...
Sizzler.
I was thinking along the lines of Vigalucci's.
What, guy? That place is for, like, millionaires.
No. I've taken girls there. Makes them feel special, feel classy. Let's give her a call.
Are you sure? I've already called her, like, 13 times today.
I'm sure. Remember, calm, cool, collected. She's a classy girl, and you're a classy guy.
Thank you. shyness can stop you from doing all the things in life you'd like to. Shyness is nice, and shyness can stop you from doing all the things in life you'd like to.
Nice shirt. Where did you get that outfit?
It was my dad's. Pretty fly, huh?
No, it's horrible. It makes you look like an idiot.
And what line have you decided on, sir?
I'll have the Beaujolais room.
What?
I'll have the Beaujolais room.
A 1970 Chateaubriand.
Very good.
Wait, do you have any shakes?
Shakes?
It's a pretty nice place, huh?
Oh, great. I love any place that has pot pies.
There's something I've been wanting to talk to you about.
Okay.
Well, you and I have been friends for a freaky long time now.
Freaky long?
Yeah. Well, and I don't know how you feel about me, but I think you're beautiful. Delicate, light, flaky.
You think I'm a flake?
No, I think you're smart. Beautiful, delicately displayed with a light.
Are you reading from the menu?
No.
Well, because what you were describing sounded pretty good.
Really?
Well, yeah, and I guess I've always thought of you as a strong and hearty man with just a dash of pepper to tease my senses.
Thanks.
I'm ready to order. I'll have the beef Wellington.
Very good, miss. And you, sir?
What's all this French shit? What about this steak with tartar sauce?
Steak tartare?
Yeah, that'll do me.
Very good, sir.
Medium well.
What?
You'll have the same as I'm having.
Very good, sir.
It's fucking service. I'm tipping that guy.
Look, Arnie, I just don't think things are working out. I'm really busy, and I'm moving back to San Jose in 4 weeks.
I know. I've been pretty busy, too. They've increased my schedule at work. 4 nights a week now. I tell you, after 7 years, I've just about had enough of that place. And the boss, Rod, he's always complaining when we're not working hard enough, and he wakes 37...
Arnie, I just
wait,
don't
wait.
Think...
Wait, first let me say something. I've never met anyone like you, and... I really feel like we have something strong, something great, and... Actually, shit. I have to go to the bathroom. I'll be right back. Oh, wait. How much do I tip the guy who gives me the towel?
$1? Minimum. No credit cards. No charge cards. Bank statement. Rod character. Your boss. I'm just
fascinated. Dur être bébé.
Oh, yeah, bébé, c'est dur être bébé. Oh, yeah, bébé, c'est dur être bébé. Dur être bébé.
Abajan. Nice threads.
Hey, D.
So where you been at? Ain't seen your shit since forever, yo.
Been busy.
Keeping yourself busy. That's cool. How you handling the breakup?
Breakup?
Yeah. That girl, Danielle, from the bar.
What makes you think we broke up?
She didn't break up with you on that date?
No, what makes you say that?
You broke up with her?
No, what do you think I've been doing all week?
You've been doing her all week.
We've been hanging out all week, if that's what you mean.
So, guess you made her feel classy.
That's what my life is about, self-improvement.
And you've continued for this past week to make her feel classy.
Yeah, I guess. Hasn't been cheap, but you have to live life, you know.
Cheap.
Dropped about 8 G's in the last week. What?
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 What'd you do yesterday with her?
We went shopping.
And you spent how much shopping?
I don't know. About $1,200. Quality isn't cheap.
What?
What?
Where'd the rest of the money go?
Well, we went to lots of places to eat. We bought lots of clothes. Put a CD player in her car, balloon ride, ski trip.
You don't even know how to ski.
Maybe I wanted to learn.
You didn't last year when we all went to Mammoth.
Oh, sorry if I didn't want to hang out with you fags in a ski lodge.
No, it's because you didn't want to spend the money on a single lift pass.
Well, maybe I do now. Look, I'd rather actually hang out with my girlfriend. She's actually fun. I'm like, you fucking losers. You don't know what it's like to have a girlfriend like that.
Because I don't have that much money lying around.
Man, I'm actually having so much fun. We're even talking about marriage.
I bet she has.
Look, she even helped me pick out my clothes. I'm in autumn.
Hmm. Yeah.
And check out this turtleneck. Not only does it go with my eyes, it shows off my posture.
Turtlenecks. The only people who wear turtlenecks are abused kids and my dad.
You're so fucking jealous. You really do need to find a girlfriend. She has so much energy. She's beautiful and she's so cool. You guys should meet her.
Yes. I'm gonna speak with her.
She's coming over in a little bit. I'll bring her by. But remember, mind your manners. She's a lady.
These are the guys that live next door. They also work at Gianni's with me.
Hey, Abajan. This must be Danielle.
Hi! Hi.
Oh, Mike, Arnie has told me so much about you. I feel like I know you.
Hi, Danielle. Nice to meet you. Why don't you couple sit down?
And you must be dear, sweet John.
No, just John.
It's so nice to finally meet you both.
So, Danielle, what do you do?
I'm working in the marine biology department at Scripps.
Oh, so what's inside a marine look like?
No, I regulate the temperature, the pH, the food, and keep track of births.
Ever been tempted to a free willy?
Hey, sweetie, I'm gonna go get a drink. What do you want?
Oh, a beer, sweetie.
Diet Coke?
Sure.
What the hell are you doing?
What?
I know exactly what you're doing. Stop it right now.
Stop what?
Hey, Abajan. Your woman here was telling us how good you are in the sack.
Oh, yeah. Baby's good to mama.
Has he told you about how he got so good? About the peanut butter?
Peanut butter? You never told me about it, sweetie.
Yeah, tell her about it, sweetie. It's a really sweet story.
I'm fucking chill.
What's the story?
He just wanted to get really good at cunnilingus. Yeah, so we convinced a retarded girl up the street to let him practice on her. But in exchange for not telling, he gave her a jar of peanut butter.
Is that why you're so good? Whatever happened to this girl? I am the jealous type.
She moved away. To Texas, where she got executed for being retarded.
Oh, no.
Yeah, apparently her last words were...
Yeah, but I like the things she was saying. Imagine. We have to get going. We have appointments at the salon for haircuts.
Yeah, and I have to get waxed. Sweetie, do I go for a Playboy or a Brazilian?
What's the difference?
Well, a Brazilian is bare, like a baby. And a Playboy is like an upside-down champagne glass. You know, the landing strip. Let me show you.
Wow.
I think we're gonna be late.
Wait, Arnie and I are going out tonight. Do you guys want to come with us?
Sure.
Great, I'll pick you up at 8. John, you're invited too.
I know. Don't look at me, I avoided a stripper. No, you didn't. Well, no, but I meant to.
What the fuck are we gonna do? She's gouging.
What do you mean? What's the problem?
The problem is, in 2 weeks, Abajan's gonna have nothing. No money, no Danielle. Empty as John D's soul. And he'll blame us.
Yeah, rightly so.
Well, that sounds like the end of every relationship every guy I know has ever had.
But not you.
Nah, the ladies have to pay for the Latin lover.
Yeah, in penicillin and topical ointments. Hey, just get Danielle to end it. Prematurely. Like she does everything else.
Dude, come on. Besides, she wouldn't. You saw how arrogant she was acting. She owns him and she knows
it. Dude, who cares?
Exactly. You should try and be like John and I. Whenever we get stressed out, we relax with a little FP.
FP?
FP Santangelo. The baseball player? Yeah, you guys in your sports.
Meaning?
Come on, let's go get some lunch.
John, do you come in?
Nah.
Relaxing with a little FP?
Maybe. Dude, stop it with that FP shit. I don't think John's gonna think it's funny.
You're worrying way too much about that. Like this whole Danielle thing. Maybe you should be the one who's going after her.
What guy? To break up her and Abajan?
No, really, go after her. Do you really think this is all about Abajan and his money?
Yeah.
You're not worried about Abajan's savings. Weren't you telling me about the time you were thinking about ways of stealing all his money?
Yeah, but...
Man, you don't want to help Abajan out. You want to help yourself out. Like you and Danielle, you were going out with her, right? But she didn't have sex.
Yeah, she just wasn't the one.
Yeah, the one.
Yeah, well, what about her?
Her? She's easy. She's a sexual girl. All this is to give you the impetus to finally make that move. I mean, do you really think that any woman would want or even need $200 badly enough to sleep with Abajan? If a girl had those kind of standards, she'd be out on the streets working her goods for 10 times that a night. Believe me, I ought to know. Those girls call me Cappy. See, the truth is, chicks are usually gagging for it as much as a guy. But they've got all these societal voices telling them that they have to be selective when it comes to breeding. Now, take a guy like me. Cocky, aggressive, hung. They know that if they're halfway decent, I'm not gonna reject them for sex. Now, being rejected for sex isn't a big deal for you or me. It happens all the time, though more often for you. But to a woman, it's the ultimate disgrace. Broads always know that the one asset they have is their snatch. That is the only skill that every one of them possesses. It is really the center of their being. Any little college girl knows that if she needs cash or grades, all she's got to do is open up that little love box. The very possibility of being rejected for sex is to reject a woman in her most basic, most primitive form, because we're really just sex organs with legs. We were made to breed. You see, that's the problem for guys like you. Sensitive, respectful, caring. They know that you might actually reject them. But they see a sex machine like myself, who will nail anything that moves and give them a good time. Once the alcohol kicks in, society gets an oily rag stuffed in its mouth.
Enough of your doctoral thesis. I just gotta bring this thing to an end.
Relax. Just because you helped get this thing going does not mean you're responsible. Just think of the fact that you hooked up two friends and money was involved.
Fine. Jerk. So that's the story. You hate me?
I'd forgotten how much nicer men are to their friends than women. You guys talk so mean to each other, but you're also so loyal. Your friend could be the biggest asshole, but if you've been friends since the third grade, then you would do just about anything for each other. It amazes me. I would never go through near that much kind of trouble to help a friend get laid. I just would have figured that his personality was God's way of keeping him from procreating.
Abajan does need help. What do you think of the three worst characteristics a guy can have?
Bad shoes, bad breath, and being cheap.
God damn, that was fast. Was that some kind of hidden female manifesto? No. Why do you think that Abajan has never had a real girlfriend? Why do you think that Jeremiah would rather go shooting than on dates? Why do you think my brother constantly drinks and trolls junior high schools? Why is it that every woman hates Hector, including his sisters, my sister?
I hate Hector.
You too. No self-respecting girl would talk to them, let alone go on a date with them.
These are your friends.
It's what I grew up around, but that's not what I'm like.
What are you like?
I like you.
What would you rather have, a bad date or no date?
With you?
Seriously.
I'd have to say no date.
Wrong. Bad dates lead to more dates.
More bad dates.
Aren't you always telling me how Abajan never goes anywhere and is always too scared to do anything? Sounds to me like he's finally living life. It's all experience.
Maybe I could use a little experience. Doc?
Sometimes you push things a little too far.
Seriously, what do you think? You and I go on a date for real.
Like boyfriend and girlfriend?
Yeah. I mean, no. I don't know.
I'm still not over James.
I hear you. By the way, how are my shoes?
Not good.
My breath? Define cheap.
Have fun tonight. See ya.
Dude, you're not going out tonight.
Why not?
Well, for starters, your breath, dude. We weren't eating.
Minty fresh. That's my cue.
Thanks, dude. I'm blind.
I've ever seen you looking that good.
Well, considering we met for the first time today, you're probably right. So what's up, Abajan?
Nothing.
Cool. Where are we going?
Soil.
Soil? But you hate goth clubs, Abajan. You said you'd never go to one.
Oh, I didn't. I just didn't want to go and sit at a table with you fags.
So you're listening to goth now, huh? What tape is this? Merciful Realm?
I love Merciful Realm.
So does Abajan.
You do? No way.
One time, God, you can't be sweet and go. Let me see the dudes in a row.
Arnie, is that what you want? You want to see my dudes in a
row? Here we go, here we go.
Fucking Mike D, stop touching my shit. Fucking idiot, you gotta always have your hands in my shit.
My hands? Your shit?
Fucking shut up.
Cuckoo.
Well, about soil, I used to sing there, and now it's some kind of karaoke club.
Oh, is that Jeremiah?
Who the fuck cares?
Hey, what's up, you cunt?
What's up, dude?
Hey, where were Mike D and Abajan going with that chick?
That was Danielle. They're going to some club.
Really? Cool. So we're going too, right?
Dude, I don't know where it is.
Well, come on, we can catch up to them.
I'll drive.
You insist.
Weasel right there.
Wait, I don't think we want to be over there right now. Badger's drinking.
Let's get a pint.
Cool.
Arnie, get us more Long Island iced teas.
I don't know.
I do.
Danielle, your song is up.
Finally.
System up top, and in the back it was great. So then I fucked her.
What? Who's this?
I'm done with that story.
Anyway, you found some ladies for us to talk to? Evening, ladies. First time here?
What?
Hey, ladies, why don't you come over to our table? We're from the UC. We're Greeks.
You're from Greece?
Oh, I love that musical. Did you play Frenchie? I'm from Scotland.
These aren't the chicks you're looking for.
What?
These aren't the chicks you're looking for.
These aren't the chicks we're looking for.
You'd better go about your business.
Oh, we'll go about our business.
Move along.
Move along.
All that effort.
Oh man, those guys think they're so fucking cool. Let's go kick their fucking arses.
Dude, calm down. Remember what happened last time you got drunk and tried to get into a fight?
Mike.
Danielle, what are you doing here?
John wouldn't take me home, and a badger wouldn't let me in.
Tough situation you put yourself in. Come in. There's a sleeping bag in the closet.
Do you have any dry clothes?
I went to Italy a while ago, Vatican City. The tour was of all the art and jewels. Main thing on the tour was the Sistine Chapel. We all knew that the Sistine Chapel had the ceiling painted by Michelangelo, but that was all we knew. You get there and every ceiling's painted. My companions are like, "Is this the Sistine Chapel?" And I just kept saying no, because I just didn't recognize it, but I was just guessing. Then you come to this tiny hallway and it lets out into the square room where 400 people are just staring at the ceiling in a hush. I look up. It's beautiful. Like nothing you'd ever seen. And unconsciously I recognized all of it. Man touching God. All that stuff. Suddenly it was clear.
Have you ever found that?
I think I have.
The morning sunshine.
Yep. Morning. I see it. I'll go put on some pants and drive you home.
Drive me home?
Yeah. I gotta go to work today.
Work? What time?
I'll go brush my teeth.
I'm sorry I have to work today. I'll call you, okay?
Okay.
Danielle, I'll call you, alright?
Danielle? Hi. I know. What is it? What?
You know, Abajan, what was up with your drunk chick?
What? Danielle, she's pregnant.
What?
What?
Yeah, she took two of these tests. She's definitely pregnant.
What are you gonna do?
What am I gonna do? What am I supposed to do?
Don't worry about it. She's a smart girl. She'll get rid of that kid.
Yeah, she wants to. She needs money though, $1,000.
Yeah, it's cheaper than a kid, right? Besides, you got the money.
But I don't want her to do it. I'm gonna ask her to marry me.
Okay, are you serious?
Yeah, I was thinking of going to get her a ring.
Come on, Abajan. I got a video return. Let's go.
Can we stop and get a ring?
Sure. Maybe.
Would you tell him?
No. Yeah?
Have you seen a gallo?
You're selling pico de gallo?
No, a rooster have been taken.
I have no idea what you're talking about.
Can you at least give me some less money?
Look, kids, I told you. Oh.
I thought you'd never leave.
Your baby's daddy?
Aren't you gonna ask me in?
Why the hell did you tell Abajan you need $1,000 for an abortion?
Well, it's true.
God damn it is not true. You've pulled that shit on so many guys and told me about it. I'm ready to fucking smack you right now.
Well, I hate to wake you up, Mike, but sometimes people do get pregnant.
Yeah, and sometimes people lie. Sometimes people say anything to get money from people, no matter who it hurts.
Look, I don't know if you feel responsible because he's your friend or if it's because you got us together.
What about my
fucking power trip you're on? You're not God.
What about my responsibility as a human being?
Well,
if this
well,
is some
no.
way...
If it isn't the high maintenance chick everyone keeps talking about. Why do you need money for an abortion? You can get coat hangers for free. I mean, I got a whole closet full. Let's go right now.
That's not funny.
Oh, why?
Because I've had 3 abortions.
Wow. The war against the unborn, you're like a general or something.
You're an asshole.
Well, maybe you should use some protection. Otherwise, people might think you want to get pregnant.
Why would I want to get pregnant?
So some idiot would marry you? No one's offered yet, have they? Didn't God like you right now?
Mike, I'm going home.
I think you should go deal with your sweetie.
Oh, I can't see him like this, can I?
Why not? Would he deny you? Your makeup looks weird? I wouldn't. I'm not even picky.
Fine, I'm leaving. Fuck you guys.
I got a 20. Chicks.
Hello, Kurt?
Danielle, is that you? Why haven't you called me?
It's a long story.
How are you?
I miss you. Things are really bad here.
What's the problem?
These guys, they won't leave me alone.
What do you mean?
Some guys, they wanted me to have sex with this
what?
Guy. They wanted me to be a prostitute.
You had sex?
Money. Yeah, I didn't want to, but I really need the money and I couldn't find you.
I was on the Springer show in Chicago.
Really?
Yeah, well, too bad your roommates don't give you your fucking messages.
Yeah.
Honey, I'm coming down now. Where do these guys live?
It's 8 hours away. I just called to talk.
The time to talk is through. Action is required. I'm on my way.
Wipe out! 1, 2, 3! My country going down the drain. We are all at fault now. We are all to blame.
So what is it?
We last night I was lying in bed and I was thinking, you know, life really is so complex.
More complex than what you're trying to tell me?
I was lying in bed thinking about the trip I took to Italy. Specifically the Sistine Chapel. You ever been?
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah, in Vatican City.
Oh. Well, remember walking and walking and come to this tiny hallway and it lets out into this square room where 400 people are just staring at the ceiling in a hush and... Remember how long it took to get there, and when you did, it was finally worth it? Because everything that was beautiful in your life in pieces was suddenly laid out for you in one big canvas. There it all was. The Genesis on one side, the apocalypse on the other, and every emotion in between. And suddenly everything made sense.
Yeah, I guess.
Well, it's how I feel about you. You know, feels like we've been known each other forever. And you've had boyfriends, I've had girlfriends, and they come and go. I want more. I see and I feel all this. Why don't you? We'll be right back.
Don't try and mess with the master race, nigga. Face to face. Don't try and mess with the master race.
Wait.
What?
Isn't that some of the Sistine Chapel? Did you put that out there for us?
No. I mean, yes. I don't know.
Wait a second. That stuff you said about the Sistine Chapel, is that true? Was that me, or was that some line you picked up?
Yeah, line? No, it's true. You're my Sistine Chapel, I swear.
It just... sounds like something from a cheesy old movie.
Erica, you're my Sistine Chapel of Love. You're my only reason...
Is that Danielle?
I don't think so.
Mike, it's Danielle. Are you home?
Hi, Danielle. How's it going? Why aren't you at Abajan's?
I came over to tell you something. I'm going over to Abajan's. I'm going to tell
you. Danielle, Erica and I don't want to hear about your financial matters.
No, I know. I want you to.
Know that you are going to tell Abajan the truth. You're not pregnant. Fine. I understand.
I don't understand.
I know you don't, and that's your problem. Get going.
Well, we made love.
You and Abajan? Erica and I don't want to hear about this. Let's go.
No, you and I. We slept together the other night.
What?
What?
When you said all those things about love in the Sistine Chapel, why do you think I put all this up?
I do it.
You're just like your friends!
Excuse me, you know where 1807 Brookstone Lane is?
Great, Danielle. Thanks.
What, don't you want her to know the truth?
The truth? The truth is that right after I had sex with you, I realized that Erica is the only girl I want to be with. I should thank you. You cleared things up for me. But besides that, what happened between you and I was nothing more than a drunken mistake. Much like your conception. Chicks.
Wait in the car. I'll take care of this.
So how was it?
What are you talking about?
You don't think I knew? You don't think I could figure it out? What am I supposed to think when she comes over to your house and leaves crying? I heard you that night. Next time you plan to fuck my girlfriend, close your fucking front door!
Imagine it was a mistake.
Homies before hoes! You can't even respect the guy who's lived next door for you for 10 years! The one girl that liked me! The one thing in my life that was good and pure!
She wasn't that pure.
I'm talking about love, motherfucker!
Love, motherfucker?
Fucking Mike D, motherfucker.
Why?
Dude, why you gotta tell Hector and Jeremiah about my business?
Your business?
Yeah, the FP. Do you think I'm stupid?
FP?
Fake pussy.
I don't know what you're talking about.
My fake pussy.
John D, I've never seen that before.
It's my own fucking business. I don't go through your shit showing everybody. I didn't tell anyone about your bi-curious profile on Yahoo. Yeah, Mr. Give and Take 08. He's making himself look like an asshole. Wait.
John D, do you have any peroxide or bleach?
Hey, any new homies want to leave?
What should I do to him?
I don't know.
Can I at least get a ball gag?
Kurt,
I think I speak for everyone here when I say you can take Danielle with you. Be happy together forever.
She's pregnant!
With whose kid?
Mine!
No, it's yours, her.
Really? You mean it?
You know I do, babe, but you're the only one.
Oh, honey, you are now a white mother.
Quick, get some Propecia.
I shave, you idiot!
Brazilian or Playboy?
Kurt! I don't think you realize something.
I told you to shut up!
Kurt, I agree things aren't going well here, but if you look, I think you'll see we have a common enemy.
Why, is he a Jew?
No, not Hector. Women, specifically woman, Danielle.
Don't you dare speak badly of the woman carrying my child in the future of the master race.
The science speaks for itself.
Science?
Did you know that chimpanzees only have 3 chromosomes different from us? Only 3.
Out of how many?
52. That's not much. Women only have 1 chromosome different from us. That means if there were only 2 more chromosomes different, they'd be a different species altogether. Women are the weaker sex, and they know it, and they play us against each other. Danielle's been playing you. She's cheated on you more times than I can even count.
Danielle.
Well.
It's true. She manipulated my friend here out of $10,000.
17.
Yeah. How much has she gotten out of you in the past 3 years?
About 56,000.
What?
Yeah, I had to get a second job programming computers.
She is crafty, I'll give you that. She's beautiful, and yes, she is Aryan. But you can't limit yourself. You need to find someone who will love you for you and hate others for their appearance.
You know, Danielle, it's true. You have hurt me a lot.
See? You play us against each other. Poor courtier has driven 8 hours for you and probably stayed angry the entire time. And that shows love. Well, dedication. So Danielle, please tell us. We're dying to know. Where does all this money go? As far as I can tell, you've taken $100,000 from the guys in this room and a couple others I know of.
What?
Yeah, sorry, Kurt. So tell us, where's all this money going?
You want to know?
Yes.
All right, it's all going in.
Right. Move! Go! Go! Go!
Hey!
That was for La Raza!
Yeah, that's for his Raza.
Orale.
You are a bitch. What the hell are these?
Freeze, police!
Sight is the popo!
Down, ground! You, drop your guns!
My guns?
Down, now!
What's going on here? Who's responsible here?
Mike D.
Mike.
Who's Mike?
My bad.
Thanks, folks. You'll have a good day.
It says here, when our deputies came into your house, they found one beat-up skinhead who's been arrested several times for hate crimes with a shotgun in his possession, one handcuffed girl who may or may not be a prostitute, some potential Johns, and 3 handguns that were used to kill a family pet. No one has made any statements, so the only thing we can do is charge you for the possession of the 3 handguns, 2 of which killed a family pet.
3 handguns? Family pet?
Bastard! Mi gallo está muerto!
Gallo?
A chicken, a family pet.
I don't know anything about that. I was throwing a party, and those guns were probably left by some unruly partygoers. And I was going to return them to the authorities, but I was so busy entertaining.
That's your story?
Yes, I guess.
Well, that's not good enough. Either you tell us the whole story or you go to jail. Explain yourself or go to jail, you choose.
Well, jail, I guess.
How would you like to plead?
What exactly am I pleading guilty to?
Killing a family pet, shooting within city limits, being in possession of 3 handguns.
I was in possession. I'll plead guilty to that.
Well, with no priors, I'll give you 2 months for the handguns and another 2 for killing the chicken.
It was a rooster, you hon, or a bonito rooster.
Fuck that rooster.
Who said that?
Why would I kill this woman's rooster? I don't know her or her rooster.
Hang him, you honor. Hang him.
Right. One more outburst at you and I'll hold you in contempt. I'll give you 1 month for the Benito Rooster.
I don't know anything about it.
Then you're not pleading guilty?
No, I just don't want to go to jail for killing a rooster. Can you just give me a fine for that?
Miss, how much is a Benito Rooster worth?
Priceless!
$10 fine.
What?
That's it. We'll now break for lunch.
What would you like for lunch, Your Honor?
What, Your Honor, what about my trial? What about my day in court?
Court? You pled guilty. I dropped the other charges. You aren't going to court. You're going to jail.
I thought that I was... Man, this is nothing like the practice.
Your Honor?
I don't know. KFC?
What?
Hey, did you guys see who's on the cover of Fortune?
You know, we should be getting a portion of that $1 billion.
Why?
Well, after all, aren't we investors? Didn't we help fund her sex empire?
Hey, I paid way more than you leeches. Although I haven't seen dime one. I'm happy with the joy she brings me every day.
And night.
By the way, Abajan, how does this Danielle compare to the real one?
You should know, you slept with her.
Yeah, only once.
Yeah, well, me too.
Really?
Yeah, but it's all right. After the initial payment, this one's quite a bit cheaper, and the difference is, well, this one likes what I wear and doesn't demand I go spend money on expensive meals and clothes.
Yeah, I mean, I finally got a woman to accept me for me.
An ambitionless alcoholic?
Yeah.
When are you gonna fix her teeth?
Fix them.
Hey, do you still have that FP?
FP?
Yeah, the fig, pussy.
Dude, I don't know what you're talking about. Probably wanna mic these practical jokes.
You know, John D's got a pretty good point. I mean, for the first time in our lives, we're finally being accepted for the men we are.
But aren't there some things you miss?
Like what? The nagging? The visits from the cops and the pimps? I mean, look at her. She's perfect. Perfect temperature. And she keeps her big fucking mouth shut. Unless I want it open.
I know. And it's nearly impossible to bruise these babies.
Well, I have to admit, mine's just improved my life. No mind games. No friend-girlfriend ambiguity. And when I brought home that mannequin the other night, she was down. But are you worried about Kurt and Danielle having $1 billion?
Like what? You afraid they're gonna clone Hitler or something?
You know it wouldn't be so bad. We've all got Danielle's. All those women we're leaving out in the cold, they gotta have someone in their lives. I mean, look how happy Ava was. Up until the end.
Dude, aren't you gonna pick her up?
Nah, she's good.
Go fish.
Poker.
Consider a cheating.